Hello everyone, welcome to our very first technical overview video in the Partner Innovation video series. I'm Basak Mutlum from Azure IoT engineering team. I'm a principal program manager leading our digital twins ecosystem through strategic partnerships, and Capgemini is one of those strategic partners. Today we are talking with Alban Alev and Thomas Perpere on their digital twin solution for operational efficiency and how they utilize the Azure digital twins platform. Hello guys, welcome. Let's start with the introductions. Alban?
Thank you, Basak. Hello everyone, my name is Alban Alev. I'm based in France and I'm heading the Presales and Solutioning with a focus on business bespoke solutions, especially with Azure.
And hello everyone, my name is Thomas Perpere. I work in Paris as well and I'm responsible for the Smart Digital Twin. Really glad to get a chance to present to you our solution, ReflectIoD.
Thank you, Thomas and Alban. It's a great pleasure to have you on our show. Alban, what is ReflectIoD? What does it do? Could you give us an introduction?
Yeah, of course. So let's start from the client challenges. Indeed, ReflectIoD is designed for owners and operators of industrial assets, such as buildings, factories, plants, or rail networks. The pain point they face is that those assets do produce a lot of data at different times of the asset lifecycle, from design to operations, in different formats, by different actors, and especially hosted in IT silos that were never designed to collaborate. So at the end, the consequence is that the asset data is totally scattered and the asset operator misses a 360 view of their assets, which prevents them from optimizing the asset value and performance or to create new digital services. So ReflectIoD, powered by Azure Digital Twins, is a unique platform in its capacity to combine all the data dimensions that describe the asset, 1D, 2D, 3D, cloud points, GIS, and IoT data. Then it exposes the federated data according to business-oriented semantic, we'll come back to that, for asset operators to monitor, predict, and simulate the behavior of their assets. The benefit for the clients, at the end, they can operate their assets in a safer, more cost-effective, and more sustainable way.
Thank you, Alban. It is indeed very important to be able to converge all these different layers of information in one digital twin. And it would really be good to see the ReflectIoD solution in action. Thomas, could you give us a flavor of the typical use cases and maybe a demo of the platform?
Thank you, Basak. So indeed, as Alban was mentioning earlier, what we see today is a lot of systems that produce a lot of data in different formats at different moments within an asset lifecycle in systems that are very much siloed. So a typical company may have a computer maintenance system, they may have some document management system, an ERP, a geographic information system, some BIM data, a SCADA, some building operating system, an IoT, and it's often very difficult for them to get a comprehensive view of all the data describing their asset. And this is where the ReflectIoD platform can come in as a data aggregation platform from multiple sources to offer a 360 view of all the information related to your asset in order to facilitate two broad families of use cases. The first one is the ability to supervise more efficiently the assets that you have in operations. And the second one is the capacity to assist field workers on their day-to-day operations with the right information to prepare or realize their interventions. On top of the ReflectIoD, you can connect some BI, AI analytics tool in order to get even more value out of the data you can collect and aggregate into the ReflectIoD platform. With that quick introduction, let me show you what ReflectIoD looks like. So imagine you're an operator and today you have a range of assets that you are operating. So here, my assets are scattered in different places. And what I want is to get more information specifically about one site, which is the Montluçon site. There is a search capability within the ReflectIoD platform, and I can quickly access the site where I want the information. So when you click on the site, you have a window that pops up. That window is the visual representation of the digital twin. It is the 360 view of my asset. It has five different types. The first one is general attributes about my asset. The second one is the relationship button. So it may be IoT sensors that trigger value that I can have access to. It may be documentation, it may be work orders. The third one is specifically for documentation. The fourth one for IoT. And the last one is for dashboardings on overall equipment effectiveness or this type of metrics that you may want to gather. So quickly, I have access to all the information relative to my site, so I can understand what is going on, maybe when it was open, the number of people, et cetera, et cetera. And what I will want to do is switch view to my 3D, the 3D of my plant, in order to understand a little bit better how it's organized. So switch from the GIS view to the 3D view, very simply, in the click of a button. I'm now within my Montluçon site, so we've got the capabilities offered by the 3D. And here I have a notification stating that there is a problem with one of the equipment. This was triggered by a drop in IoT pressure. So the sensor triggered this notification, which I now see. I can see the drop in pressure in the 360 view that is updated with the specific information about this asset. On the IoT tab, I can have access on the given time frame that I would want to see, day, weeks, hour, months, where I want to visualize the IoT data. And then I can quickly access all the information relative to that equipment in order to facilitate decision-making. Less time searching for information, more time acting. Here, what I see is that I have a work order that was triggered by this drop in IoT that says there is an irregular pressure observed with a code on the pump. Okay, so this is something I need to deal with now. Let me see more details about this work order. I have here an error code D0089. Okay, so I may not know exactly how to deal with that error code. And what I would want to know is how this was dealt with in the past. And this is where we leverage the Azure Digital Twin semantic search capability. Here, what I'm going to want to do is give me all the equipments that have shown a similar problem, but that are now functional. I'll go a little bit faster on this part. But this is basically what I'm doing, kind of a drag and drop. And here I finally have my query, which is all the pumps that have a work order that shows the same error code and that are now fully functional. Alban will show in more details afterwards the type of queries we can get. We're doing a rather simple one here. It can be more elaborate. So here, give me all the equipments that have shown a similar error code that are not fully functional. I see that I have two equipments that fit these specific characteristics. I can access those two equipments to see where they are located within my plant. And I'm going to look specifically on this one. So when I click on the info button, I can have all the information relative to that specific equipment that are very quickly available for me in order to understand which one it is, when it was dealt with, maybe some of the maintenance procedures, some of the IoT values, et cetera, et cetera. And what I'm going to want to do now is enter and capacity again of the system to switch from one representation of this asset being a 3D view to another representation of this asset here in CMMS tool. Here with an integration we did with Maxibo, it could be another. So now I'm going to switch to that same equipment, but in Maxibo. And here what I can see is in Maxibo the details relative to that specific item. And what I'm going to want to do is look at the previous work orders. So I can see that there was a replace the pressure regulator. I can access that specific work order. I can look at the specific procedure that was done in order to replace this. So I have the step-by-step, look at the supply line, find the valve, stop the flow, replace the regulator, open the flow, etc., etc. And now what I'm going to want to do is copy-paste that work order into my existing equipment, which is today non-functional. Very simply in Maximo, I'm duplicating the work order. And now this work order is in my non-functional pump ready to be taken care of. Now, one thing, I'm positioning myself now as the operator that has to realize this maintenance. So the first capacity that I have is within the system to see some of the past work orders that have been dealt with. So I can quickly see, you know, there was a replacement of all packing, a lubrication of the bearings, so quickly understand what was done, the specificities of that equipment. I can open the documentation in order to properly understand or in more detail the characteristics of that equipment. So I can access the documentation that, again, would be hosted in another IT system. So no login, logout, finding the right equipment, etc. Just available, just a click. And I can understand the equipment in which I'm going to operate, but also the environment in which I'm going to have to realize my intervention. Here, the capacity to do measurements in the system. So I can see whether an equipment is going to fit, etc., etc. Very quickly, understanding the characteristics of the equipment and preparing my intervention more efficiently in order to minimize the number of interventions that would not be successful, the time to prepare my interventions, or the time to realize my interventions. With that, I'll leave it back to you, Basak. Thank you.
Thank you, Thomas. This is really great, and I think our audience would really value the all these benefits. Like, it is really powerful to be able to see the 3D models, assets, their related documentation, and any type of information brought up, like workflow management integration systems. It is really, really powerful. So I'm sure the audience is now curious to hear about the technology that lies beneath this great solution. Alban, could you walk us through the solution architecture, please?
Yes, of course. Let's go to the technical stuff. So as you can see on that diagram, ReflectIoD is a very lean Azure architecture. From left to right, you can see that we capture the data from the various source systems. For hot sources with IoT hub and event hubs, and for cold sources such as Beam, CMMS, JS, or with Lambda connectors. Those Lambda connectors do map the data according to the digital twin description language, the DTDL target, with the rules defined by the business users. And all this data ends into Azure Digital Twins. So the 360 view panel that you have seen on Thomas' demonstration, all that information was hosted in Azure Digital Twins. As you can see, the data is also pushed to Azure Search that you could see on the demo also. And all the data is then exposed through a set of business APIs. The APIs cover project data, user data, asset data. You can also see the Forge API, where ReflectIoD leverages the great Forge technology from Autodesk to manage 2D and 3D data and their visualization in the browser, the tablet, or in the headset. Those APIs are consumed then by your React JS frontend, who also benefits from a Signaler for real-time events. This is the main part of ReflectIoD, and it's serverless. Then on the right-hand side, you can see some proxy to syndicate external applications under single sign-on that you could see with IBM Maximo in Thomas' demonstration. In that way, the end user accesses the 360 view of the asset with a single application.
So, Alban, ReflectIoD has been in the market way before Azure Digital Twins, right? I know that for a fact that you guys were using a different database to store the relationships and etc. What were the main drivers for you to choose Azure Digital Twins and migrate this great solution onto Azure Digital Twins?
Yes, indeed. Well, ReflectIoD has the concept of a flexible data model, which is really at the core of the system of ReflectIoD. And thanks to its DTDL, Azure Digital Twin has been a great and robust and scalable way to implement the flexible data model. previously were using Cosmos DB and doing the, let's say, the graph semantics query by ourselves, but we have seen with Azure Data Twin a native, genuine way to do it in a scalable and robust way. So Capgemini has created sector-specific templates, I mean DTDLs, but more importantly, those templates can easily be adapted to the real life of company or project specifics.
And this is great to hear. And one of the real differentiators of your solution and also Azure Digital Twins is that scalable semantic query capabilities. It would be good to hear like how you are unveiling this in maybe new customers, right? Azure Digital Twins has been generally available since December 2020. And I'm wondering whether this solution has been implemented in any customers. And if yes, like what were the benefits?
Yes. So as you could see on the demonstration, we have shown a very simple semantic query that used three concepts, a pump, a work order, and a sensor. Indeed, with our clients, we have focused on, let's say, more complex business questions. And for instance, for a chemical plant construction use case, the issue or the requirement was to easily identify the pipes that were delivered on site but not yet mounted, but whose structural support was mostly installed, so that the client could easily prepare their installation the week after. So this question involves more than 10 business concepts, and the semantic query could be defined within minutes with ReflectIoD, thanks to Azure Digital Twin. For that particular client, the benefit was obvious: to save time and optimize the construction sequence according to the actual progress. So every day, they can review these semantic queries and analyze what should be done next week very easily. So this solution has been implemented for energy and utilities actors, and it's also in pilot for railway infrastructure operators. And generally speaking, the benefit that we have observed is basically the time to access the right data that releases time to focus on the business of asset operations and maintenance.
And it is really great to hear this and really looking forward to maybe a second episode of this video series where we can host some of those customers in the future. And one thing you have mentioned is like, for Toma, I understand that it's a really like hurdle for our customers to scale these type of solutions, right? In the demo that you have shown, it was, I believe, one site. But what are your experiences on it? How do you use the Capgemini experience for scaling such solutions in large production scale?
Yes, indeed, Basak. So the intent and the motto really for Capgemini and for ReflectIoD is let the data in. So focus first on a set of data and some use cases that will bring value to our customers. So to some extent, quote unquote, start small, but with benefits, and then use the flexibility of the platform to leverage, increase the number of use cases, increase the data, and hence you can start with a relatively reasonable set of data and use cases, but scale. So time and cost can be minimized or at least optimized.
Thank you. It was a really great conversation and really thanks for your time to be on this show. And looking forward to hear more in the future about your customer experiences. Thank you, Alban and Toma.
Thank you, Basak. Much.